Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to Smartphone World. Realme 7 Pro, the all-new budget smartphone from Realme, packs best-in-class budget gaming processor from Qualcomm, the Snapdragon 720G, which should provide good gaming experience. In this video, we are going to put Realme 7 Pro to test and see if the phone can handle long gaming session. Before we get started, this video is sponsored by Sprig, a brand that creates premium durable tempered glass for smartphones at affordable prices. Use coupon code 20OFF to get 20% discount on all tempered glass purchase from Sprig website. Check the links in description for more details. We are going to play 3 high graphics games continuously for 60 minutes and check the temperature and battery of the phone on frequent intervals to see if there are any heating issues. First, let me show the temperature and available battery on the phone. The battery is at 71%, the ambient temperature is at 31 degrees and the phone's temperature is around 34 degrees. Let's launch Call of Duty, a high graphics intensive shooting game from Activision. Let's start with the multiplayer game. First things first, the graphics looks awesome and the controls are pretty easy. As you guys can see, the graphics were set to very high and I tried everything in the game from running around to shooting enemies. Arduino 618 GPU handled everything smoothly. I did notice occasional frame drops when the graphics were set to high, but overall the gameplay was pretty smooth. Realme 7 Pro has dual stereo speakers that provides best sound quality. But in high volume, the vibrations from speakers are so pronounced that you can feel the vibration throughout the phone. I have used Realme UI's inbuilt screen recorder to record the gameplay as well. Even then, there were occasional frame drops or hiccups. Overall, the gameplay was pretty smooth. It's been more than 20 minutes since we started the gaming test. The battery has dropped from 71% to 64% and the temperature has raised from 34 degrees to 39 degrees. In just 20 minutes of gaming, the phone was slightly warm to my liking and I feel that the phone's temperature was slightly high. For the next 20 minutes, let's play Free Fire and see how Realme 7 Pro handles the game. I played a survival match and I set the graphics to high. Overall, the gameplay was pretty smooth and there were no frame drops or hiccups even during intense action. Snapdragon 720G proves that it can handle high graphics game. It's been 40 minutes since we started the gaming test and the battery dropped from 64% to 56%. The bad news is the temperature of the phone surpassed the 40 degree mark and now is around 41 degrees. I feel Realme could have done a better job in handling the thermals in Realme 7 Pro. As PUBG is banned in India, we'll play Asphalt 8 on Realme 7 Pro for the next 15 minutes. We'll start with quick solo match and then we'll switch to career mode. In Asphalt 8, the graphics was awesome with ample amount of details in car and racetrack. I was driving the car intentionally towards other racers to create frequent crashes. A point to note here is I have been using Realme UI's inbuilt screen recorder to record the gameplay as well. This in turn will add more load to the processor and GPU and might take a toll in battery life. I am pushing the phone to its limit, playing games at high graphics, recording the gameplay, and as you can see, Arduino 618 GPU and Snapdragon 720G handles all the tasks I throw at them with ease. The clock has surpassed the 1 hour mark and the battery has dropped from 56% to 51%. Surprisingly, the temperature of the phone dropped from 41 degrees to 37 degrees. You can see a pattern here. If you play high graphics game, the temperature of the phone rises quickly. But if you play normal and casual games, the temperature of the phone is not rising as quickly as it did while we play high graphics game. In Realme 7 Pro, the battery drained at a slightly faster rate compared to other phones. The heavy graphic games drained the battery by 20% in just 1 hour and 10 minutes. To put things into perspective, Note 9 Pro Max battery drained by just 15% after 1 hour and 15 minutes of gaming. So let's conclude, if you are a normal gamer and if your budget is around 20,000, then Realme 7 Pro is the best all-round gaming smartphone. But if you are an avid gamer, then Realme 7 Pro might not be the best option as the phone tends to heat if you play games at high graphics. I would suggest you to look for other options like Poco X3. I have already uploaded gaming test videos of Realme 7, if you guys are interested, please do check the video. Before we conclude, a word from our sponsor Sprig. a brand that creates premium durable tempered glass for smartphones. You can buy Sprig tempered glass from Amazon, Flipkart or Sprig Store. You can download the Sprig app from Play Store and iOS app is coming soon. All the links will be in description. So what do you guys think about Realme 7 Pro's gaming performance? Share thoughts in the comment section. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to Smartphone World for more tech videos. As always, do what you love no matter what the outcome is. I'll catch you guys in the next video and you guys have a great day.